And we're back. I rebooted Discord and it starts by itself as I wanted. And there's still one package manager available, so still one package to do with the package manager, and that's this guy. But they're building or changing the package build as we speak, so let him do it. So this is the SSD that we started in November the 7th. So a clean installation at that point in time and just updating. November the 7th, the 8th, the 9th, 10th, November 11th, 19th. This was our Plasma challenge. Why don't you test out Plasma? Because it's really changed. If you've done it, say 2-3 years ago, you'll see that's a huge difference between then and now. So March 5th was the last video, and now we've made a video June 12th. For the updating, and we're back. So this is the latest kernel. We have 5.1.8, but of course we still have this number here. We're gonna fix that as well and see what we've changed in the meantime and what we should not install in Plasma ever. So there are some pitfalls, potential pitfalls if you don't know what you're doing. All right, 18.12.7. There are lots of videos out there telling you SuperShift return that. There is this little file, etc lsb release, and it's just nothing more than a little file. I do want to be demeaning about it. It's not important in life, but you can open it with Sublime Text. And in this file, you can say, I'm gonna give it the name 7300. I don't know, number clock was not on. I can give it a ridiculous number. Oh, fine, password, save, and then you do neofetch and you get this beautiful number. My point being, it's just a number. Okay, so that's one thing. At this point in time, we are at a version that's much higher. Right, it's 19.07 actually already for us, but officially 19.06.1. Let's have a look. We have this bin folder and we have this stay rolling folder, and there is something in here that says, look, we have a version or something to go from 18.11 to 18.12. So let's open everything up. Let's see if I can open it with, I guess I'll better do an Atom this way. And this one can go. Can it go? I need to change it later. So I'm gonna use like this. Bye. Yes. Okay. Titled. And then use the project folder. Add project folder. And use home control H the dot bin. I'm gonna open it like this. Why? Much easier for me. You have a folder and I'll go over every folder. So Samba things stay rolling. Some of the things we need still to do, we need to do or not do, change, we're gonna read them. So Samba is probably already fixed since it was in March last time, but let's quickly have a glance at it. If I should do anything, this is already fixed. Stay rolling. This is something you should never install. Quantum Qt 5 and Quantum Theme Arcs, all the quantum stuff is not installed. And we did install it prior, had lots of issues with it. It's out of here. So that's an important message. Stay rolling. Transmission is out. But I guess this is, KDE, or it's KTorrent. So it's your choice to actually say, I'm gonna install this or not. But starting from this one, I've added a line, you see? And it's just change me this version into that version in etc lsb release. So if we wanted to do this, this version, control C, should be in here. If we want to use scripts like that, it needs to, control Z, it needs to find something like so. Save, done. So now when I ask what's my version, it says 1901.4 because I just typed it here. It just gets these numbers, right? Now, when we run this, this bunch of lines is going to be replaced with this bunch of, well, lines, articles, characters, that's it. So replace me this thing with this thing in etc release. So basically 19.1.2, that's the one. Yep, that's the one. We go to actions, open terminal here. I could say stay rolling. It's trying to remove transmission, which is not there. So it's gonna say I did not find it, but it can of course run this line, qbtorrent. He's going to install qbtorrent, which is okay for me. I like to do that. And he has changed the versions. Well, we can have a look. He has changed indeed the version. He changed it to 1902.4. Control T. I'm now at 19.02.4. Great. Keeping analysis. Let's analyze further. So the Git version had a problem, had an issue. Don't recall that was it. Orphaned. So nobody was taking care of it. Basically, that's what it means. But there is also just an Arch package and not coming from Git, not coming from AOR. This is probably AOR, and this is just Arch. So we're going to install that one, which is good. Redshift, if you don't like it, don't install it. It makes your screen a little bit redder by night. It's softer for the eyes, etc. This is a search thing like Catfish. It searches inside files. I do want to have that one. And we already have this one. I've seen already my grub. You can't see it at the point of booting, but I've seen it, so reinstalling it won't do anything. And we've removed hplib, which is for the printers. If you have an HP printer, you better keep it. And we're changing again the file from 1902.4 to 19.303. All right, all good for Plasma. Actions, stay rolling. That's out. It was already out. No, it was not installed. I'm gonna reinstall it, it seems, or not. No. This is new installation. Okay, we have a new icon theme. Redshift is going to be installed. This one is going to be installed. It's yay. So it's from AOR. This is going to be reinstalled, same version. And hplib was already gone. And hopefully we've changed again to another version, which we can't see now. NeoFetch. We're now at 1903.3. So this last line ran as well. Then we go to March, stay rolling. They moved this guy to AOR, so we've removed it. This was moved to AOR and is orphaned. Nobody wants it. Umox, it's a terrible thing to build. We got rid of it. And it's for, well, making themes and all that, but basically not for Plasma. So I do think it's not for Plasma. So as good as it's out, reinstalling. So when we remove this thing, it's going to remove that and that one as well. And I want to keep it. So I'm going to reinstall it after this one. Okay. And then we've moved to the Arc themes from Nico. So Nico Hood is a new maintainer of the Arc themes, not Horse 3180. And we're going to change 1903.3 to 19.0.4. Okay. Sounds all good to me for Plasma. Let's go to stay rolling. So that was installed, is gone. That was installed, is gone. Scrolling up, something red. Umox was not there, so it's not uninstalled. And it's reinstalling then, of course, the things that were should have been uninstalled. So that's good. And now the Arch Linux Arc themes from Nico Hood will be installed. And that's it. All right, new fetch. We're at version 19.04.4. So every time we change the last LSB release, and that's it. So 19.04.45 is this one. We saw that Redshift was causing issues, not with us as developers, but some of the users had either positive result and others were having negative responses, and we were working with Redshift did not work, blah blah blah. So no frustration, Redshift out. Those people who want it and where it works, you can install it, no problem. And that's it basically. And we have a change here from number. And Redshift is out again. And ask the new fetch. And we're at 19.05.2 already. Last thing to the June version, but June version is nothing, it's just changing the number. So nothing is changed really, just the number. What am I doing? Stay rolling. And new fetch. And there we are, Article Linux B Plasma 19.06.1. We're up to date, well, almost up to date. You know, this one package that's stuck there, but that's okay. We are patient people. Control T, this is what you get. PKSYUA, this is a machine that has been around since September the 7th and is still working, just updating everything and staying, well, rolling. That's the point of staying rolling, never install ever again. So I'm gonna keep this SSD as long as I can. All right, that's it for now. We're completely up to date and we can have fun with Plasma.